Peace be upon you and God's blessing and mercy. Mr. Chairperson, Director General, it's my pleasure to transmit to you the greeting of the State of Qatar, and I take this opportunity to congratulate on behalf of my country Ambassador Abdul Wahab Balouki, Ambassador of the Kingdom of Morocco, for chairing this session. We are confident that his competence, his experience will contribute to the success of this session, God willing. I also take this opportunity to thank Ambassador Christoph Isrank, Ambassador of the Federal Republic of Germany, for his able stewardship of the last session. I also wish to express our appreciation and thanks to Ambassador Ahmed Osumshu, the Director General of the OPCW, and also the Technical Secretariat staff for their efforts to strengthen the role in the OPCW in undertaking its mandate under the Convention. In this regard, I wish to congratulate Ambassador Fernando Reyes, Ambassador of Spain, for his appointment as the next Director General of the OPCW under the recommendation by consensus from the Executive Council. I wish him all success in his mandate. Mr. Chairperson, the State of Qatar renews its commitment to implement its obligations and work to preserve stability and peace all over the world and combat terrorism and contribute in doing so with peace-loving nations in order to realize the stability, security, and prosperity of humankind. Thus, we, since our adherence to the Convention, we did not spare any effort in implementing all articles of the conventions. In implementation of Article 7 of the Convention, we have established our national authority in 2004. This body is the one responsible for taking steps and necessary measures to follow the implementation of the Convention in the State of Qatar, in coordination with the relevant institutions. Also, under Article 7, we took legislative measures and we promulgated Law Number 17 of 2007 concerning the chemical weapons. That law was amended with Law Number 16 of 2013. Also, on 2012, we have established the Doha Regional Center for Training concerning treaties on WMDs in cooperation with the OPCW. This center is the only one of its kind in the Middle East and in the Asian continent. The State of Qatar, through the Doha Regional Center, has organized 26 programs and events in cooperation with the Technical Secretariat of the OPCW. In this regard, I wish to avail myself of this opportunity to thank the OPCW in its confidence, for its confidence in the ability of Qatar to host and organize these events. The Regional Center also has organized training and awareness activities for secondary and higher education students, for customs officials, also for the personnel of the chemical industry and for the civil defense. This confirms our active and leading role in education and outreach activities. Mr. Chairperson, just like the OPCW, we give high importance to planning for the future activities. This calls for capacity building in all relevant areas, including chemical technologies, chemical safety and security, also the promotion of the useful applications of chemistry for the benefit of mankind, also assistance and protection measures against chemical weapons, all this through the implementation of Article 11 of the Convention. Mr. Chairperson, we commend efforts and achievements by the OPCW with respect to the destruction of 96% of all declared chemical stockpiles all over the the world. We also appreciate efforts made by the OPCW with respect to the elimination of Syrian, of declared Syrian chemical weapons and their production facilities under verification by OPCW inspector. Mr. Chairperson, my delegation has viewed the report of the OPCW fact-finding mission in Syria dated 2nd of November 2017, establishing the use of sarin in Latamana on 30 March 2017. Also, my delegation has viewed the conclusions of the 7th report of the Joint Investigative Mechanism. Thus, the state of Qatar condemns the use of chemical weapons, which is a blatant violation of all the provisions of the convention and also the relevant resolution by the UNSC 2118 of 2013, and also the relevant decisions of the OPCW Executive Council. This is also a blatant violation of all established international laws and norms against chemical weapons. The state of Qatar is of the view that the Joint Investigative Mechanism needs to continue its work until those responsible for the use of chemical weapons are identified and brought to justice. Mr. Chairperson, the report of the Director General dated 4th of October 2017 states that the unresolved issues with regard to Syria's declaration and its related submissions, those issues are still, has not still been resolved. Therefore, we wish to express our support to the Director General in the continuation of the work of the fact-finding mission in Syria, as well as the declaration assessment team, until the EC determines that there are no more concerns with respect to Syria possessing chemical weapons. Also, the state of Qatar requests the Director General retains the relevant information and make them available to help the Joint Investigative Mechanism continue its work and undertake its mandate. Mr. Chairperson, the state of Qatar reiterates its call towards states that has not yet joined the convention, and we call upon those states to do so. We also look forward to the complete destruction of all declared chemical weapons worldwide in order for us to reach a world free of chemical weapons where fraternity, justice, and prosperity would prevail. Finally, I wish that this statement be treated as one of the official documents of the convention, and peace be upon you.